Hi everyone and welcome back. I am excited to be sharing with you my latest laser cutting experience, and this week I'm using a portable version called the F1 from Xtool. So despite its small size, the F1 packs a powerful punch and it's capable of cutting through a variety of materials including wood, acrylic and leather. So in this video, I'm going to share with you my favorite materials to use, how to adjust settings for optimal results, and then show you some creative ways to use this powerful tool. So I'm going to be lasering an AirPod case, my external hard drive just for fun, and because I can, my phone case and some holiday projects. So this little machine is so easy to set up. It took me all of, let's say, 10 minutes to get started. First things first, let me just show you how easy it is to set up the F1 laser machine. So once you receive the package, just unpack everything really carefully, and inside you'll find the F1 device along with a power adapter and some instructions. You're simply going to plug the power adapter into a power outlet and connect it to the F1 laser machine, then plug the USB cable and connect that to your PC. And then once the machine is powered on, open up Creative Space. This is a user-friendly interface that's really easy to navigate. And it's free from Xtool. And now that we're all set up, let's just talk about the amazing features of the F1 portable laser machine. So despite its small size, it does have a powerful laser beam that can cut through a variety of materials, so wood, plastic, acrylic, and even metals. So if you're in the market for a laser cutter but you don't have the space for a larger machine, or you're someone who frequently attends pop-up shops or craft shows, then the F1 might just be the perfect fit for you. One of the biggest differences between this model and the M1 that I've showcased previously in my videos is basically its size. The F1 is much smaller and more portable than the M1, and this makes it incredibly convenient to transport from one location to the other. So I've also bought a pack of 3mm plywood from Xtool. I really can never find sheets this large elsewhere, plus the wood grains are really pretty too. And despite its small size, the F1 still packs a powerful punch. It's capable of cutting through a variety of materials, including wood, acrylic, leather, and metals. Let's get on with the first project, and I will be showing you the settings I've used for each project, but just bear in mind that you may still need to do a small test patch. Depending on your material, it might not be the same as mine, but the settings I'll show you will be a great starting point for you. Framing is really easy to do with the F1. You can select the button on the right of the machine to frame where your design will go. And there are two framing options available. The first one will cast a blue outline light beam. And yes, you can put your fingers underneath. This is just a light and not the laser beam. And then the second version is also a blue beam. And this time it will be the outline of the actual shape of your design. And I'll show you that one further on in this video. I think it's always a good idea to do a quick framing just to make sure that you're not off to the right, the left, and make sure that everything's centered in your design. And then once everything's framed, you can just press the button on the actual machine itself and that will start the laser going. And depending on the complexity of your design, some designs are really fast and some will just take a couple of minutes or so. So for this project, I am going to use my AirPods and I'm going to use a really cute music design on the front of it. And the settings that I've done for this one is stainless steel. I've used the laser type infrared, so the IR, and the dot duration is 550. The power is 100 and I've just done one pass. And this was actually pretty fast to do. And you can also see I've done a little test at the bottom just before. And what happened was I did one pass of the music notes. I didn't think it was deep enough, so I've basically left it in the machine and then I've just done the exact same pass with the same settings once more. And as you can see, with two passes, I actually preferred the depth of it much better. So this worked out really well and it was actually really fast to engrave. So now I am going on to some holiday projects. I need to engrave on these black bags. I actually did this same project in a previous video using the M1. So for this I've used the setting for corrugated paper, the blue light, the dot duration is 300, the power is 40 and the DPI was 300. And I've then turned it around and I've done a more intricate design on the front of it, and I've used the exact same material settings as before. And this works really well because the black bag, which actually is a white bag, and I'm assuming it's coated in some sort of black paint, and this works really well because it lasers off the black layer and leaves you with a really bright white design engraving underneath. And this is actually one of my favorites, and I've done probably all of my black bags really quickly in this F1, so I'm really pleased with that. And now on to the next project. I'm going to laser engrave on these bamboo coasters that I've bought. And for this one, I've used the wood coaster setting with the blue light, a power of 100, a speed of 200, and I did just one pass. And I think I've chosen the standard 200 lines per inch, but if your design is very complicated, you might want to up that. And what I love about the engraving on these bamboo coasters with the setting is that it gave it an almost an inlay effect. So there's a slight groove in all of the design. It really does look cool. So if I shine it in the light, you can see it. It looks flat on the top, but against the light, it's slightly inset. And for the next project, I am going to be cutting some 3mm plywood. And I wanted to show you the second framing option. This is the option that actually gives you the blue light beam of the outline of your actual object. So the settings I'm using for this 3mm plywood is 3mm plywood as the material. I've chosen the blue light option and got it to cut at a power of 90, a speed of 3, and just one pass. So once these have been cut out, just a little spray of some white spray paint on all the pieces, and then just add some spray glue, or you can also use some PVA, which I preferred in the end. And then the fun bit, just sprinkle on some glitter. Lots of design choices, also a really fun project to do with kids around the holidays. Well, much like myself, I run workshops for adults around Christmas time and they love this project. We're never too old to have some artistic fun. So overall, I am really impressed with the F1 from Xtool, and if you're looking for a reliable, portable and easy to use laser cutter, this is definitely a machine worth checking out. Anyway, thank you all for tuning in. I'll see you next time.